am with Dr. Heather Rushford, a board-certified plastic surgeon, and she is joining me today, and we are going to talk tummy tucks.
Tummy tuck is actually one of my most common procedures, and women that, and typically I'm seeing women that have had a few children that after their babies they have loose skin, especially after a C-section. A lot of women will get that scar right there, and then they have what we call the blurpus. That just sort of, it's not a technical term, but just sort of flops right over that scar.
Really?
And it, no matter how much exercise or dieting, they just can't get rid of that extra skin. And also with pregnancy, the muscles, the rectus muscles of your abdomen spread apart. And so that no matter how many sit-ups you do, you can make the muscles stronger, but they're spread apart. And so your lower abdomen pooches out, and a tummy tuck can take care of that.
Okay. And that's what most of us battle with, is that
right.
little pooch, no
right.
matter how big or how small,
yep.
it's there and it's unbelievably
yep, you're constantly
frustrating.
Sucking it in,
yeah.
trying to camouflage it
right
with,
now.
Yeah, Spanx and all that stuff. Yeah, tummy tuck is the answer.
Okay, so what won't a tummy tuck do?
A tummy tuck is not going to change the thickness of your abdominal wall up here. So depending, generally people will say, do I need to lose weight before my tummy tuck? If I have loose skin and extra fatty tissue down here, do I need to lose weight? It depends on the thickness of your upper abdominal wall and what kind of changes you want to see there. So,
where do you mean the abdominal wall?
So like the
right
stuff you
here.
Can grab
okay.
up here. So this thickness isn't going to change. It will pull the, it will make the skin tighter, make it look much more youthful.
Okay.
But if you're a little thicker from, you know, front to back, that's going to stay the same.
Okay, so it's not like the liposuction
it's
where
it's not like liposuction where it's taking the fat out, right? And some
okay.
people will combine liposuction and a tummy tuck, and I will commonly combine liposuction of the flank area or the muffin top mm-hmm. because the tummy tuck doesn't take care of that in addition to a tummy tuck.
Okay.
I don't liposuction this area during a tummy tuck because it diminishes, it puts the blood supply at risk, and I
oh,
want to
sure.
minimize complications with that.
Sure, that's what I was just going to ask. What are the risks involved? Obviously,
that's the main one. Risk with tummy tuck that we worry about is infection.
Yeah.
And then the other one is wound problems, wound healing problems. And because when I take that skin, I pull it down and I create a tightness there. And if you pull skin too tight, you can minimize the blood flow and cause skin necrosis or skin death. And so that's an open wound down there, which nobody wants. Typically, young, healthy people or even people that are a little bit above their ideal weight aren't going to have a problem with that. Smokers or people that have a BMI, body mass index in the 30s or higher are going to have a higher risk for that. And so that's
okay.
what we try to manage.
So when you pull it tight, it's not so tight that they can't move. It's still elastic and still...
Right. Skin always relaxes.
Okay.
And so the first week after surgery, people will be a little bent over. But by the first week, after a week, people are able to stand up straight for the most part. Some people, depending on the tightness, will take a little longer to stand up straight. But
is that because they're afraid to stand up or is that just recommended?
It's just tight.
It's just tight. So that's just where they are.
Yeah, and
it
hurts to stand up straight right away. And then, but by a week's time, most patients are able to get fully upright.
So what if someone comes in and say they've had a couple kids already, they get the tummy tuck and then, oh, baby comes again. Can they get, I mean, what happens in a situation like that?
That, you know, the majority of patients, the abdominal wall will stretch again.
Okay.
We don't want to do that, obviously, because it's going to wreck your result.
Right.
And so the best thing is to make sure you're done with children. But generally, if you have a pregnancy after a tummy tuck, it's not going to impair the pregnancy. There's a potential when we tighten up the abdominal wall that that may not stretch as much. Mm-hmm. But generally, that doesn't occur because the skin, the body has so much elasticity in it.
It could just be potentially repeat business, right?
Correct, yeah. But most of the time, you want to make sure you're done having children before you do that.
Right. So do you see immediate results with a tummy tuck?
Yes, you'll see an immediate result where your stomach is flat. You can bounce a quarter practically off of it.
Really?
Yes, so it's very rewarding.
What are realistic expectations for someone coming in who's interested in a tummy tuck?
Realistic expectation is basically everything from the lower abdomen is going to be removed and tightened. The belly button is going to stay in the same place, but it's going to come out through new skin. If we don't liposuction, the hip area, any fatty tissue that's there is going to stay.
Okay.
As far as expectations in terms of pant size, majority of women will find that their clothes fit them better. Probably 50% will say, I'm going down a size in my pants. If we add liposuction, then that percentage of people that are going down in their pant size is going to go up to more, the
sure.
75 to 95%.
Okay.
So you're going to change sizes for sure.
Yeah. What is the full beginning to end recovery period? Or does it vary for each person?
It's pretty standard at 6 weeks that people are feeling close to their normal self by 6 weeks. But it can be, you know, shorter or longer depending on your individual health and circumstances.
So any advice for someone who's coming in to get a consultation on a tummy tuck?
If you're bothered by your lower abdomen, don't wait. A lot of people will say, oh, I'm going to lose that next 10 pounds, and the kids are, you know, 17 years old. And so don't, you know, we beat ourselves up enough about our bodies and say, oh, I'm going to put this off until I'm at my ideal body weight or until I've lost that.
Right.
Don't wait. Come in. Let's talk about it so that at least you know what your options are. And then if you decide to schedule a surgery, you can use that surgery date as your goal. And then you have something really concrete to work towards to lose if you wanted to lose some weight.
Right. Dr. Heather Rushford, thank you so much for joining us.